One, Andy Gardner, always known for his singing and his speeches in the Rose Club. And then there's myself bringing up the rear. I don't know what he meant by that. I says, Bobby, I've no really got a problem with that, because I know, getting forward be used to, there's one of you's got to make me look handsome, and there's another got to make me look really thin. Actually, Bobby, it was nice to see you because I was really concerned about you. Somebody says to me on Sunday morning, they seen you Saturday night and there was something wrong with your legs. They weren't working. Can I just say, it's an honour and a privilege to be standing here toasting the Brig, a place where I was born and brought up. When the Provost asked me to do the toast, I asked him, what do you talk about? He says, talk about growing up, when you were growing up in the Brig. I thought, Provost, what kind of memory do you think I've got? However, I would just like to point out that I wasn't born in BC, before Cummins. Anyway, when I was young, you always knew when the marches were coming round. My dad, he cut her hair every year, all year round, he cut her hair, right into the wood. As you can see, I still keep that going. But just before the marches, my mum used to take us into Tammy Anderson's. We got the same haircut, just without the lumps to out the heat. Then we went for the rig out for the marches. A new t-shirt, usually white, with a wee pattern on the front. White shorts, pair of white socks, and a nice wee pair of plastic sandals. Mind of them, Raymond? You just had to hope it wasn't roasting or your feet would stick to the ground. You know, host us. That's all right. Alright, back in these days in Linliithgow Brig, it was a different place. We had the two paper mills, Lovells and Chalmers, and nowadays you'll find these sites both few houses. You've got Lovells Glen and Avalon Gardens. And then where Lennox Garden is, that was the BRS. Where Sainsbury's, the supermarket is, that was Russell's at Bathgate. And all these working places used to put in floats for the marches. And it was always great because when they come out to Linliithgow Bridge, everybody got on the floats. We're all fine to go on the floats. I can remember my mum putting me on the float with one of the mill floats. She says, I'll get you down at the cross, son. 6 hours later, I was still standing here. I always knew she'd never like me. And then there was a rag man. Oh, yous boys, you must be open mind to that. No. My mother used to lock the doors when they come round because we used to come in better dressed than what we went out to them. The Brig was a great place to be. It was quite had a few colourful families in it. We had the whites, the browns, the blacks and the greens. Right, Derek. Then when I was a wee bit older, I joined the Cubs. What a life. Joyce McGuck, wife of Jim, the clerk of the court, she was a pack leader called Shep Khan. I believe she still calls Jim Baloo to this day. I come in, we entered the float, the black and white minstrel show. You want to get away with that now? Aye. Anyway, we came second. Folks say lollies for coming second. I don't know what you get for coming second now. Pat in the back. In recent years, the young'uns have had a float featured a number of times, and they were all lads for the Brig. The boys used to entertain us, usually dressed as women. In fact, after a couple of years, I fancied a few of them. And then, as I got a wee bit older, Jews cry it the October week, we cried it the Tatty week. We used to come there, the trailer used to come out with the firm of the trailer, and all the youngsters, 12, 13 year old, mothers, fathers, uncles, sisters a lot, on this, away to the Tatties. Should have put these in the right order before I come up here. The late Sandy Smart, well known to a number of fraternities, would come into the brig with his tractor and trailer and take us to the tatty fields. The best bit was me was when it was peace time. All you folk from Springfield, guess what we got in our peace? Spam. So you're no as snobbish as you think. Well, folks, I think that's about time for me to let other people say something. But before I go, I'd like to thank you for listening to my memories of the brig. We've reached the brig and crossed the river. And the brig folk cheered. It made me shiver. A shining place in the Borough Royal. Friendly faces and people loyal. A special place on Marches Day. The processing marches through as a reed band play. So join me, please, on it now. Those tunes... those tunes they play make my heart dance a jig. So join me, please, and toast the brig. Yeah.